بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful, I begin with you tonight, inshallah, on this day, which is the 10th of the month, the 11th month of the Islamic calendar, Dhul-Qa'dah, of 1425 after the Hijrah, the migration of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام from Mecca to Medina, which corresponds to Wednesday, the 22nd of December 2004 of the current era. Begin with you the discussion on a book by Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, which is called Al-Wasiyyatu al-Sughra, the concise admonition, which is called the concise admonition. Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah is Taqiyuddin Abu al-Abbas, nickname Ahmed, son of Abd al-Halim, son of Abd al-Salam, Ibn Taymiyyah al-Harrani, born in the year 661 after Hijrah, on Monday, the 10th or the 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal, in the year 661, corresponding to 1263 of the current era, in Harran, and he grew up in Damascus, Syria. His family was renowned in scholarship and in rank. His grandfather is Majduddin Abdus Salam Ibn Abdullah Ibn Taymiyyah, who died in the year 652, corresponding to 1254. Himself an imam in many Islamic disciplines. And his father, Al-Shihab Abdul Halim Ibn Abdus Salam, excelled in fatawa, religious verdicts, and other disciplines. His father was the Khatib and the ruler of Harran. His mother is Sittun Ni'am bint Abdul Rahman ibn Ali ibn Abdus al-Harraniyyah. Sittun Ni'am bint عبد الرحمن ابن علي ابن عبدوس الحرانية. She lived for more than 70 years and died in 716, corresponding to 1316. Ibn Taymiyyah had three brothers. Muhammad died 717, corresponding to 1317, a scholar and a faqih, one who possesses knowledge in Islamic laws. His other brother is Abdul Rahman, who died 747, corresponding to 1346. Himself is a Zahid. What is a Zahid? A Zahid, one who leads a pious life, devoted to Allah, taking the least that is sufficient of the lawful things of life. It does not mean to abandon lawful means of earning property, children, etc., nor exaggerating in performing acts of worship. This is Zuhd. Himself, he was a Zahid and devout worshipper who volunteered himself to be imprisoned with Shaykh al-Islam in Damascus and in Alexandria in order to serve his brother. and Abdullah the third one who died in 727, corresponding to 1327, a known scholar who defended the beliefs of the Salaf against its opponents from mystics, from the mystic Sufis and the later or the latter Ash'arite sect. Seeking knowledge. Sheikh al-Islam grew up under the care of his father. He studied with his father and was recognized for his strong memory and fast comprehension and deductions. He marveled time and spent his life engaged in learning, teaching, enjoining what is right and forbidding what is wrong, without transgression and with jihad and writing, da'wah, standing against all forms of innovations and perseverance in all of this. He mastered various disciplines of Islamic studies at an early age, and he was authorized to issue fatwa, religious verdicts, at age 19. He was authorized by Imam Sharafuddin al-Maqdisi al-Shafi'i, who died in the year 694. He used proudly and happily say, "I was the one who gave him the permit to issue fatwa." This is mentioned by Imam Ibn Kathir in his book Al-Bidayah wal-Nihaya, volume 13, page 361. His sources of knowledge. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah memorized the Quran, learned the Arabic, hadith and tafsir before he reached 20 years of age. He studied the Quranic sciences and the Sunnah, the six books of hadith, Musnad Ahmad, Sunan al-Darqutni, Mu'jam al-Tabarani, the science of hadith, fiqh and usul and foundations, the various deviant sects, lexicology, writing, arithmetic, history, medicine, geometry and other disciplines. He excelled in his learning to the extent that you would think that he is a specialty on each of the disciplines he studied. The number of the scholars he studied with exceeded 200. May Allah's mercy be upon them all. In his circle, whenever there was time for tafsir of some verses, the entire class will finish and he's still in one or two of the verses. And his majlis used to stay for one fourth of a day. Anyone who would be present would read something before him, and then he begins to make the interpretations and tafsir. And in the tafsir of Surah Al-Ikhlas, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ, he had an entire volume. And in the tafsir of Ar-Rahmanu عَلَى الْعَرْشِ اسْتَوَى, Allah ascended, the most magnificent, ascended the throne. It was compiled in 35 booklets as to his knowledge and insight in the Sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Then in the Prophet's sayings, actions and his entire Sunnah, knowing the authentic from the inauthentic, and what is related by the companions in their actions and their sayings and their fatwa and their conditions, and what Allah qualified them in the merits he bestowed upon them. He was so concise and precise in all of that, most knowledgeable about them. Rarely a hadith is mentioned or someone cites except he would refer it to its correct reference and he would classify it as to what type of sahih it would be or what type of authenticity it may be. And he would also relate the narrator of the hadith from the companions. Al-Imam al-Bazzar, who wrote a biography about him, he said from the amazing things during his trial and test that he went through in Egypt when he was put in jail and his books were prevented from reaching him, he authored many books therein. And he mentioned in there the ahadith and the saying of the scholars and the names of the muhaddithin and the authors and their books, and cited everything to its sayer and to its reference, naming the name of his references, all from memory, because he didn't have anything with him. And when that was checked after him, it was as he said, without changes. The fruits of his vast knowledge, well-researched and comprehensive scholarly views which are based upon al-dalil al-sahih, authentic textual proofs, and free from blind following. Secondly, a strong defense of the sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Thirdly, a firmly stand of jihad with the pen and by the tongue against innovations introduced by philosophers, scholastic theologians, and esoteric and mystic cults, including many of the mystic Sufi orders, the Rafida, the Shia sects, who on numerous occasions plotted for his imprisonment in Damascus and in Cairo. Even in prison, he continued to call for the righteous predecessor's way of understanding of Islam, so much that his opponents were driven to deprive him from writing material. And he said, commenting on his imprisonment, he said, quote, "What could my foes do to me? My paradise is in my heart, and my garden is in my chest. It does not leave me wherever I go. My imprisonment is a khalwa, is a retreat. Killing me is a shahada, and deporting me from my country is a siyaha." Siyaha meaning traveling to expose Allah's creation, carrying with him the cause of Islam and enjoying da'wah for the sake of Allah. He strongly defended the names and attributes of Allah and all aspects of aqidah, of creed. When he confirmed the attributes of Allah as confirmed in the Quran and the Sunnah, and without any alterations in their meaning, the innovators from the people of scholastic theology plotted against him, and he was sentenced to jail. And when they led him to his cell in the Qal'a prison in Damascus, and they closed the door, he smiled and recited the following verse. Can we have this verse, please? In Surah Al-Hadid 57:13, he recited the following verse: فَضُرِبَ بَيْنَهُمْ بِسُورٍ لَهُ بَابٌ باطنه فيه الرحمة وظاهره من قبله العذاب. So a wall will be put up between them with a gate therein. Inside it will be mercy and outside it will be torment. He once said, quote, "The truly jailed one is the person who withheld his heart from Allah, and the confined one is the person who confined himself to his desire." Ibn Taymiyyah physically defended the Muslims in Ash-Sham in Greater Syria against invasions by the Tartars and the Tartars are a member of the Mongolian horde which overran Asia and part of Europe in the Middle Ages. He died in the year 728 after Hijrah, corresponding to 1328, while in jail in Damascus. His great student Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah, who was with him in the same cell, said he was reciting the Quran, and when he finished reciting the verse from Surah Al-Qamar, إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي جَنَّاتٍ وَنَهَرٍ فِي مَقْعَدِ صِدْقٍ عِنْدَ مَلِيكٍ مُقْتَدِرٍ. Verily, the muttaqeen, the pious and righteous persons who fear Allah much and love Him much, will be in the midst of gardens and rivers, paradise, in a seat of truth, paradise, near the omnipotent King, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shaykh al-Islam had many students and companions. 25 of them were prominent scholars. 25 of them were prominent scholars, including the great scholars of Islam, Imam Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyyah, 691, died 751, Al-Hafidh Ibn Kathir, died 774, Imam al-Zahabi, al-Muhaddith al-Balzani, 665, 739, Imam ibn Abdul Hadi, 704, 5744, Al-Hafidh al-Mizzi, 654, 742, Ibn Muflih, Ibrahim al-Zara'i, 688, 741, Burhanuddin al-Dimishqi, died 797, Ibn Shaykh al-Hazzamin, Ahmad ibn Ibrahim al-Wasiti, 657-711, Al-Shaykha, the woman scholar, Umm Zainab, Fatima, bint Abbas, bin Mahmud, al-Baghdadiyya, Imam Ibn Taymiyyah highly praised her, praised this great alima, scholar, in her manners, as well as in her knowledge and understanding. She used to attend his learning classes and raise good questions. She later had her own classes in Damascus and in Egypt. Many women memorized the Quran under her supervision. She stood firm against the people of bid'ah, of innovation, and many people benefited from her knowledge. She, rahimahullah, may Allah's mercy be upon her, died in 714 in Egypt, amongst others. Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, received knowledge from more than 200 scholars in all disciplines of Islamic studies. He excelled in fatawa when he was less than 19 years old. It did not take him too long before he began to write. His writings reached 500 volumes. His funeral took place in Damascus. Ibn Kathir wrote describing it, quote, people closed their shops and all came except the weak. Those who could not attend resorted to dua, asking Allah's mercy upon him. An estimated 15,000 women attended his funeral. Others were on the roofs of their buildings, all asking Allah's mercy upon him. All cried. Men attending the funeral were between 60,000 and 100,000. Other estimates reached 200,000. The funeral prayers were conducted at the Umayyad Mosque in Damascus. The funeral prayers, many saw good dreams about him. May Allah's mercy be upon him. Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah was very knowledgeable about the doctrines of other religions and philosophies. He wrote many treatises about different religions and mystic sects. defending the oneness and uniqueness of Allah and proving that the true essence of religion revolves around the fact that Allah deserves